For this lesson, you need to open the sample file First Quarter Sales and Profit 4 from your Sample Files folder. Sometimes, you'll want to select all of the cells in a column. To select all of the cells in column A, I first hover the mouse cursor over the letter A at the top of the column. This is called the column header. You can see that two things have happened. First of all, the column header has lit up in green. And secondly, the cursor shape has changed to a black down arrow. When you see the black down arrow cursor shape, click once and every cell in column A has been selected. You can see that all of the cells in the column have become slightly shaded and a green outline now surrounds all of the cells. You've actually selected over a million cells. Now suppose I want to apply the bold attribute to every cell in column A. I'd click Home on the ribbon and in the font group the Bold button. And I've not only applied the bold attribute to all of the text in column A, but also into any text that I might type in the future into any other cell in column A. Let's now remove the bold attribute from all of the cells in column A. Once again, I'll hover over the column header until I see the black down arrow cursor shape, click once with the mouse to select every cell in column A, and then on the Home tab of the ribbon in the font group, I'll click the Bold button, and all of the text returns to normal. Sometimes you'll want to select more than one row or column. Suppose I wanted to select columns B, C and D. To do that, I'd hover over column B until I see the black down arrow cursor shape, hold down the mouse button and drag across to the other columns. And you can use exactly the same technique for rows. First of all, I'll hover over the row header for row 5, hold down the mouse button and drag down several rows to select them all. Let me now show you a different technique that can be useful when you need to select a large number of adjacent columns or rows. Now you could drag across them, but it's often easier to use the following technique. First, I'll select column B. Then I'll hold down the Shift key on the keyboard and click on the column header for column O. And you can see that I've now selected every column from column B to column O. Sometimes you'll want to select non-adjacent rows and columns, rows and columns that are not next to each other. To do this, first select a column, then hold down the Control key on the keyboard, and you can then select any other columns, even if they're not next to the column that you originally selected. And you can use the same technique for rows. Select a single row, hold down the Control key, and then you're able to select any other rows. And you've now completed Lesson 2.6. Select adjacent and non-adjacent rows and columns.